I posted this video about the June 6th recall about 1 week ago on YouTube. The main point of this video is that there were not enough voters voting on June 6th to justify the 969,000 ballots claimed by the Central Election Commission. Therefore, the recall of Kaohsiung City Mayor HanKuo-Yu was illegal. In order to get 969,000 ballots, an average of 66 people were required to be voting per hour around Kaohsiung in order to get that many. However, that was not what we saw around Kaohsiung. 66 people per hour means that there needs to be a line at most voting stations around Kaohsiung for all 8 hours. However, that is not what we saw even in busier areas, that is districts with high population centers. The Taiwan Fact Check Center, a non-governmental organization, has deemed this video to be fake news, and therefore people in Taiwan cannot post this video to Facebook. This video has been posted on at least 3 different channels on YouTube. However, as far as I know, mine is the only one that is blocked by the Taiwan Fact Check Center on Facebook. The Taiwan Fact Check Center is specifically targeting my channel to be blocked on Facebook. They have something personal against me, and not necessarily this video. Other channels with more subscribers have posted it, and they didn't block those links. This is actually the second time that the Taiwan government has deemed one of my videos to be fake. The first video, posted on March 28th, was also deemed fake by the Central Election Commission, although no explanation was given. Point 2 of the Taiwan Fact Check Center says that 66 people per hour on average around Kaohsiung is incorrect. However, this is correct. On June 6, 969,251 total ballots were cast, according to the Central Election Commission. There were 1,823 voting stations, therefore 969,251 divided by 1,823 is 531.679 average number of ballots cast per station. From 8 a.m. to 4 p.m., there are 8 hours. 531.679 divided by 8 equals 66.459 ballots cast per hour on average. Just over 1 voter per minute means there needs to be a line at most voting stations for all 8 hours because it takes a voter on average about 1 minute to complete voting. The locations compiled in the video are from 8 different districts in Kaohsiung, and 5 out of those 8 are in the top 10 population centers in Kaohsiung. Therefore, they are fairly representative of Kaohsiung. If there is no line in 5 out of 10 of Kaohsiung's top 10 population centers, this casts a very large doubt on whether or not there were enough actual voters voting on June 6 to recall HanKuo-Yu. Point 3 says that the video shown does not encompass all of Kaohsiung. However, let's look at how much of Kaohsiung it really covers. There are 38 total districts in Kaohsiung. There are 21 video clips in the video. The 21 video clips are from the districts, and they are numbered to the right of each district in the parentheses. 14 out of 21 of the video clips are in districts in the top 10 population centers in Kaohsiung. Therefore, based on the Central Election Commission's official results, we should definitely see 66 voters per station voting. However, we didn't see that in the video.
This 高雄投票总共开出96万票左右，有1823个投票所。 以投票所的数量与人数来换算，一个小时需要有66个人进入投票所完成投票，而这66个人还必须在1分钟内完成量体温、核对身份、盖章、领票、进票柜圈票，再投入票箱。这样的情况下，8小时必须是没有间断，人潮要全部排得满满的才能够完成。可能吗？当天投票有这样多的人潮吗？
就算是在人多的地方，还是没有到66。 个人平均一个小时，也是后来开始下雨了，就人就变得更少。
更少。
对，所以它下雨差不多三个小时。那我不是说下雨就不可能有九十三万票，我的意思是，就算那一天没有下雨，它还是没有办法到九十三万票。
OK。
OK。
也就是说，投票率没那么高了。
以下就是投票当天的录影，这才是真实没有造假的民调。从这里我们可以清楚地看出，那93万罢韩的票许多是黑箱作业灌票而来的。高雄新兴中学上午9点，内有多个投票所，却很少人去投票。高雄女中上午9点多，内有多个投票所，很少人去投票。前金国民小学上午9点10分，内有多个投票所，很少人去投票。博爱国民小学上午9点20分，内有多个投票所，很少人去投票。三明市立图书馆上午9点25分，内有多个投票所，很少人去投票。大荣高级中学上午10点20分，少人投票。鼓山七贤国中上午10点25分，少人去投票。投票所内外空空的，极少人投票。九如国小上午10点35分，少人去投票。新兴国小上午11点8分，少人去投票。爱群国小上午11点20分，少人去投票。复兴国小上午11点40分，少人去投票。还有以下许多抽样拍到的录影画面，所显示的都是投票的人数稀少。这样的光景所呈现出的投票率连20%都不到，罢韩不会过关。很显然，民进党实随之位，每到选举就习惯性的搞台面下的手脚做票。而到了下午开始下雷雨之后，有些投票所就更没有人去投票。从这些民众录影的资料中，我们清楚的看到，6月6日去投票的人很少，根本不可能出现90几万人的数字。这情形又与总统大选一样，少人投票，开出的票数却多。那么这些大量的选票是怎么灌进去的呢？
If you look at the Facebook link in the comments, you'll see some of the users are saying stuff like 崩溃 or collapse. This is what the 1450, the 1450 like to say on Facebook and YouTube in the comments. Therefore, you can tell that the Taiwan Fact Check Center is strongly supported by DPP supporters and the 1450, who are basically the same people as the 1450 most likely. Therefore, we can fairly easily conclude that the Taiwan Fact Check Center is not in fact a neutral NGO. This is an NGO that's clearly in line with the Tsai Ing-Wen administration. Recently, I went to the Central Election Commission page on Google Maps and left a comment. Since the Taiwan Fact Check Center is trolling me, I'd like to troll the Central Election Commission also. The Central Election Commission in Taiwan is a rubber stamp agency for the ruling party that arbitrarily changes rules to make elections easier for it to rig and doesn't even follow their own rules. Its chairman, Li Jingyong, has a history of forging documents. The Central Election Commission rigged the 2020 presidential election and the Kaohsiung City recall of Mayor HanKuo-Yu. Then the Central Election Commission used the Criminal Investigation Bureau to interrogate me over a video I posted exposing how they used election staff to rig the January 11th, 2020 presidential election. They threatened to sue me for insulting them, quote-unquote, and making the public lose confidence in them. Try running a real election. That might help. If I had stayed in Taiwan, I would have most likely been called into the Criminal Investigation Bureau by now to make another statement regarding these last two videos that were posted. They would have asked me something like, "So who made this video?" And I would respond, "I don't know." I also left a review of the Criminal Investigation Bureau on Google Maps. So the review went as follows. I had some negative experiences here. First, they sent some detectives to my house without a summons just because I posted a YouTube video exposing election fraud in the 2020 election. They fooled me into making it private to avoid prosecution, but then they sent my case to the court anyway. I had to undergo an 80-minute interrogation while I was falling asleep. 2 months later, the judge ruled I had freedom of speech and I wasn't fined, so I made the video public again. Then they sent me another notice, a month after that, bringing me in for questioning, like the Central Election Commission was going to sue me for quote-unquote insulting them. Then the same detective interrogated me again and asked me a bunch of the same questions over the same incident and threatened me again with prosecution if I didn't give him the information he wanted. He then got mad I made the video public, even though the judge ruled I had freedom of speech. You can't trust the cops and the CIB. They were just following orders from the ruling party, always. The cops do illegal things on their behalf to suit the political needs of the presidential office, which is run by crooks these days. I reported the CIB to the UN Human Rights Council for harassment and double jeopardy. I wasn't able to find the Taiwan Fact Check Center on Google Maps, or else I surely would have left a review for them too. Why do we have an NGO with a physical address that is not on Google Maps? What are they afraid of? Please put yourself on Google Maps so the rest of us can leave comments for how neutral you guys are. Let's read what's at the bottom of the About Us on the Taiwan Fact Check Center. The center's funding mainly comes from donations contributed by enterprises, foundations, and individuals. The center posts its donations and acceptance policy on the website, stipulating that to maintain independence of operations, the center does not accept donations from governments, political parties, and politicians. Also, the center exercises its editorial control independently and is not influenced by donors. Well, based on the points that you're giving here, it appears that you guys can't even do basic math, and it certainly appears that you are speaking on behalf of the Taiwan administration. So I have some very serious doubts about the neutrality of the Taiwan Fact Check Center.